Hello guys, my name is Sharul. In this video, we will continue with our topic called as Glbp. So in the last video, we have seen what is Glbp. That Glbp is also a first of redundancy protocol, same as HSRP and BRRP, and how Glbp by default does load balancing for us. What is AVG in Glbp? What is AVF in Glbp? What is the use of AVG and AVF in Glbp? So now we will start with our practical in Glbp. You will see some basic practical in Glbp now. Okay, see, for this I'm having a topology over here. This is my topology which you will use for Glbp. I will explain you this topology. So these are my five routers where I will run Glbp. These are my five gateways: R1, R2, R3, R4 and R5. This is one user connected with this switch, and this switch is connected with five different routers. For this user to go to the internet, there are five gateways. Okay. On this LAN segment, we are using the subnet of 10, 10.0.0.0/24. We are using a subnet of 10 on this LAN segment. On R1 fast Ethernet 0/0, the IP is 10.1. R2 fast Ethernet 0/0, the IP is 10.2. Over here on R3, the IP is 10.3. Over here, the IP is 10.4. Over here, the IP is 10.5. And this user is having the IP as 10.6. On R1, fast Ethernet 1/0, which is connected to ISP, the IP over here is 20.1. And this ISP is having IP 20.2. On R2 fast Ethernet 1/0, which is facing towards ISP, the IP over here is 30.1, and over here the IP is 30.2. Same on R3 fast Ethernet 1/0, the IP is 40.1. Over here the IP is 40.2. Over here the IP is on R4 50.1. Over here the IP is 50.2. On R5 the IP is 60.1. And over here the IP is 60.2. And on this ISP, there is a loopback, that is a server, we will assume, which is 8.8.8.8. And I have configured some basic EIGRP between R1, R2, R3, R4, R5 and ISP. I will show you now the IP addresses and all. See, on R1, if you will see, show IP interface brief. On fast Ethernet 0, the IP is 10.1, and on 1/0, the IP is 20.1. On R2, the IP is 10.2, and the interface facing towards ISP is 30.1. On R3, the IP will be 10.3 and 40.1. On R4, the IP will be 10.4 and 50.1. On R5, the IP will be 10.5 and 60.1. Okay, and if you see on this ISP, the IP will be 20.2, 30.2, 40.2, 50.2, 60.2, and 8.8.8 loopback. 20.2, 30, 40, 50, 60, and 8.8. And all these routers, that is R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, and ISP, are running EIGRP. So all my gateways, that is R1 to R5, will have the route to reach 8.8 because of EIGRP. I have configured EIGRP. I have not used static route over here. If you will see, on R1, is learning the route 8.8.8. On R2, he is running the on R2, he is learning the route 8.8.8. On R3, he is running the route 8.8. Forgot about the subnet 20, 30, and 40. We will care about only the server that is 8.8. On R4, he is learning the route of 8.8. And on R5, it is learning the route 8.8. And this ISP will be having a reverse route to reply to this user, which is in 10 segment. If you will see on ISP, it will be having a subnet of 10 learned via PIGRP. Okay, so these are my basic IP configuration, basic connectivity. Now we will start with the practical of GLBP. What I will do, I will go on R1 and I will first configure GLBP. How to configure GLBP? I will go on my LAN site, which is fast ethernet 0/0. The command will be GLBP 1 IP and my virtual IP. In HSRP, the command was standby, then the group number, then the IP address. In GLBP, instead of standby, we will write GLBP, then the group number, then IP, what is the IP address, 10.10. So I have configured the GLBP on R1. I will wait till R1 become the active router, because now there are no other routers configured with GLBP. So R1 will be the only router which will become active. R1 is now active router. So if you do show GLBP, so you will get the information about GLBP. This information is about AVG, and this information is about AVF. Okay. Now, this is my output of show GLBP. I've configured GLBP on fast ethernet 0/0. And the group number is 1. The state is active. This router is the active router. What is the virtual IP address? The virtual IP address is 10.0.0.10, which I have defined. The hello time is 3 seconds. The hold down time is 10 seconds. Next hello is given 0.832 seconds. This is all normal information as you see in HSRP. As I said you in GLBP, there are two new timers. One is redirect timer, which is 10 minutes by default, which is equal to 600 seconds. And the another is forwarder timer. You can say forwarder timer, timeout timer, which is 4 hours by default, which is equal to 4 hours if you convert in second, which is 14,400 seconds. So these are the two new timers. We will see what is the use of these two timers. Now the preemption is disabled. As I said you, for AVG by default, the preemption will be disabled. The preemption is disabled over here. Active is local, that is I am the only router which is active router. Standby is unknown because now there are no other devices running with GLBP, so there are no standby routers. What is the priority by default? By default, the priority is 100. Okay. Also, as I said, you in GLBP, there will be a by default weight configured, and by default, the weight is 100. As you can see, the default weight is 100, which is default. Threshold lower one, upper 100, just ignore for now. Also, as I said, you that by default, GLBP will do load balancing for us. And what type of load balancing GLBP will do by default? It will do round robin. So, this information is showing over here that by default, the load balancing is round robin. How many group members are there now in this group? There is only one router where I have configured GLBP. So, it is showing that router information only. And one more thing I need to tell you over here. See, on these routers, I have changed the MAC address of fast Ethernet 0/0. The MAC address will be 0000000111. On R2, the MAC address will be ending with 2222. R3, it will be ending with 3333. R4, it will be ending with 4444. And R5, it will be ending with 5555. So I have changed the MAC address. So that you can remember, R1 MAC address will be ending with 1, R2 will be ending with 2, 3 will be ending with 3, 4 will be ending with 4, and 5 will be ending with 5. This is of fast Ethernet 0/0 interface. Okay. So over here, it is saying that in this group, there is only currently one member which is configured with Glbp, and what is the MAC address of that interface? The MAC address of their interface is 0000000111. And what is the IP address on that interface? It is 10.0.0.1. See, on R1, if I will show you that interface, show run interface fast Ethernet 0/0. The IP is 10.1. And what is the MAC address? The MAC address is 0000000111. So this information is showing over here. Now, till here, the information is about AVG. Till here, the information is about AVG. From here, the information will be, the information will start about AVF. So now in this group, now total there are how many forwarders? There is only currently one forwarder, because R1 is the only router which is running with Glbp. So there is only currently one forwarder in this group. So it is showing there is one forwarder. And who is forwarder number one? As I said you, that there will be four forwarder. Maximum there can be four forwarder in a group, that is forwarder one, forwarder two, forwarder three, forwarder four. So I1 is the only router, so R1 is the first forwarder over here. What is the state of this forwarder? This state is active. As I said you, that one, that a router will be in the active state for that forwarder, and for the remaining forwarder, it will be in the listen state. As I have shown you in my part one, I have drawn a table and I have shown you. So now the state is active for this router. What is the MAC address of this? The MAC address over here is showing the virtual MAC address, which is assigned by AVG. As I said you, that what is the MAC address of Glbp? It will be 0007B4XXXXYY. This XX is the group number, so it will be written as 0001. And what is the YY? YY is the forwarder number. So the first forwarder will be getting 01, second forwarder will be getting 02, third will be getting 03, and fourth will be getting 04. So over here, this R1 is the first forwarder, so he got the MAC address ending with 01. So the entire MAC address will be 0007B400001, then 01. This will be the MAC address, virtual MAC address of R1. And you can see this is the exact MAC address over here. Okay. Now owner ID over here, it is showing what is the now physical MAC address of this forwarder. So this is the exact MAC address you will see over here. Redirection is enabled. Just ignore for now redirection. What is redirection? By default it is enabled. And what is the timer of redirection? It is 600 seconds. Preemption is enabled. As I said you, that for AVF by default, the preemption is enabled, and that preemption will be having a delay of 30 seconds. So that information is showing over here, that the preemption is enabled, and what is the minimum delay of that preemption? It is 30 seconds. This router is the active router, and this router is the local router. And what is the weight of this forwarder? The weight of this forwarder is 100. It is 100. So this is the information you will see in Glbp when you will do show Glbp. Now I will go on R2 and I will configure Glbp on R2 also. interface pass Ethernet 0/0, GLBP 1, IP 10.0.0.10. Now R2 will come in the standby state. Let's wait. You will see a log that R2 is now in the standby state. Show GLBP. Still standby is unknown. Yes. Now R2 is the standby router. Now over here, you are seeing that who is the standby router? Standby router is 10.0.0.2, which is R2's IP address. And what the priority it is having? It is having a priority of 100. Now, in this group, now total, there are two devices, R1 and R2. R1 is having the MAC address as 00000111, and R2 is having the MAC address 222. So over here, it is showing that there are total two group members over here, that is R1 and R2. So what is the MAC address of R2? It is 222. And what is the MAC address of R2? What is the IP address of R2? It is 10.0.0.2. If I'm having three members, there will be three entries. If I'm having four members, there will be four entries. If I'm having five members, so there will be five entries. Now total, there are now how many forwarders in this group? Total now there are total two forwarders in this group, which is R1 and R2. So that information is showing over here that there are total two forwarders. And this R1 is the active forwarder, or this R1 is now in the active state for one forwarder. That's why it is showing one as an active. For forwarder number one, R1 is the active router. Same information you are seeing over here, the MAC address, the owner ID, redirection is enabled, preemption is enabled by default, active is local. Now for forwarder number two. Now see, for forwarder number two, R1 is now in the listen state. As I explained you in the first lecture that a router will be in the active state for that, for only that forwarder. Let's say R1 is the forward, R1 and R2 is there. R1 is the first forwarder. R2 is the second forwarder. So R1 will be the in the active state for first forwarder. R2 will be in the active state for second forwarder. But R1 will be in the listen state for first forwarder, and R2 will be in the listen state for first. R1 will be in the listen state for second forwarder, and R2 will be in the listen state for first forwarder. This I explained you in my first lecture. Same thing over here, you are seeing that R1 is in the active state for first forwarder, and R1 is in the listen state for the second forwarder. So that's why you are seeing one as an active, because R1 is only active only for one forwarder. Okay, so R2 is the second forwarder. So what virtual MAC address R2 will get? The MAC address ending with 02. Over here you will see the MAC address is ending with 02. What is the physical MAC address of this? The physical MAC address is ending with 2222, which is same over here. Redirection is enabled by default. And what is the timer? The timer is 600 seconds. Just leave what is redirection for now. Time to live, which is my timeout timer over here. The same information you are seeing over here. What is this? By default, it is 14,400 seconds, which is 4 hours. Just ignore it for now. Preemption is enabled, as I said you. You know now for AVF, preemption is enabled by default and with the delay of 30 seconds. And now who is active for this forwarder number 2? R2 is active for forwarder number 2. So it is showing active as 10.0.0.2. And what is the weight configured? The weight is configured on that device is 100, because by default the weight is 100. Now the same information we will see on R2. Show GLBP. Okay. So now R2 is the standby router, so the state is standby. What is the virtual IP address? The virtual IP address is 10.10. This is hello timer, hold down time, next hello. We have seen over redirect, forward or timeout. It's the same information. Till over here, the information is about AVG. From here, the information will start from AVF. Who is the active router? Active router is 10.1. By default, for AVG preemption, it is disabled. What is the priority of the active router? It is 100. Who is the standby router? Standby router is local, that is myself. And what is my priority? It is 100 by default. And by default, the waiting is set, which is 100. It is by default. Threshold lower 1, upper 100. Just ignore for now. What is the load balancing algorithm? What is load balancing by default? It is round robin. Total, there are two group members, that is MAC address ending with 1 and MAC address ending with 2, which is having IP address 10.1, 10.2. Same information which we have seen in R1. Now, total, there are total two forwarders. Okay. Now, R2 will be in the active state for only one forwarder. That's why it is showing 1 as an active. Now, this information is of the forwarder number 1. R2 is in the active state for forwarder number 2. So, R2 will now be in the active state for forwarder. R2 will now in the listen state for forwarder number 1. Because R2 is in the active state for forwarder number 2. So, for the remaining forwarder, it will be in the listen state. So, for forwarder number 2, his state is active. What is the MAC address of forwarder number 1? It is ending with 01. What is the actual MAC address? The actual MAC address is ending with 111. What is TT time to live? This is timeout timer, which is 14,400 seconds. Ignore for now. Just hold on. Battery is low. Okay. So this is the information of timeout timer. What is by default? It is 4 hours. We will see what is the use of this timeout timer afterwards. By default, preemption is enabled, and preemption is enabled. This is the information of AVF preemption, and by default, it will be having a delay of 30 seconds. Who is the active router? Active router is 10.0.0.1. Now, what is the weight of that router? The weight is 100. Now, the information is about this forwarder number 2, which is R2 itself. So, R2 is in the active state for forwarder number 2. What is the MAC address R2 is having? The MAC address will be ending with 02. And what is the owner ID? The owner ID, the same MAC address, the physical MAC address which you are seeing over here. This is the same thing. By default, preemption is enabled. And the preemption is enabled with a minimum delay of 30 seconds. Who is the active router for this forwarder number 2? It is local, that is myself. And it is showing what is my default weight. The weight is 100. Now, I will go on R3 and R4, and now I will enable Glbp on both the routers. Now I have enabled Glbp on R1 and R2. Now I will go on R3 and R4. Glbp 1 IP 10.0.0.10. And now I will go on R4 and I will enable Glbp. Interface pass Ethernet 0/0. Glbp 1 IP 10.0.0.10. Now total there are 4 routers in my group, and there can be, as I said, you maximum 4 forwarder in a group. So all of these 4 forwarder information now you will see in my Glbp output. R3, R4, show Glbp. Now, till over here, everything is same. Whenever you do show Glbp, you will see the same output over here. Now, because I'm having now 4 members in my group. So over here, you are seeing the information of 4 devices. Okay, so over here in the group members, as we have configured Glbp on 4 devices. So over here, you are seeing the information of all the 4 devices. what are their MAC address, physical MAC address, and what are their IP address. So earlier there were only two devices, so the information was only of 10.1 and 10.2, but now I have configured two more devices, 10.3 and 10.4. So over here the information you are seeing of 10.3 and 10.4. Now over here there are total four forwarders now in this group, and R1 is the active forwarder for only first forwarder, and for all the remaining forwarders R1 will in the listen state. So you are seeing only one as an active over here. So this is the same information which we have seen earlier, that R1 is in the active state, or MAC address, owner ID, everything we have seen. We have also seen the forwarder 2 information, but now there are two new information added, which is forwarder number 3 and forwarder number 4. So the forwarder number 3, R1 is in the listen state. What is the virtual MAC address allocated to forwarder number 3? It is ending with 03. What is the physical MAC address of that device? It is 3333, same which you are seeing over here. Then this information is all same, that redirection is by default enabled, which is of 10 minutes. Time to leave, timeout timer is by default 4 hours. Preemption is enabled with a default of 30 seconds. Who is the active router? What is the IP address of that active router? It is 10.3. And what is the weight? The weight is 100. So seeing primary over here, just ignore for now. We will see what is this primary. Same, the information you are seeing in forwarder number 4. R1 is in the listen state for forwarder number 4. What is the MAC address allocated to forwarder number 4? It is the ending with 04. What is the physical MAC address? This is a physical MAC address. This is redirection timer, timeout timer. Preemption is enabled with a delay of 30 seconds. Who is the active? The IP address is 10.4. And what is weight it is having? It is by default 100. Same information you will see on R2. Earlier there are only two forwarders. Now if I do the same command again, so now you are seeing there are total four forwarders, and in my group members there are two new devices added, which is 10.3 and 10.4, the MAC address and the IP address. Now this information is of forwarder number 3 and this information is forwarder number 4. If I go on now R3, show GLBP. Now this information over here is of AVG information. Now R1 is the active router. R1 is now the active router. And who is the standby router? Standby router now it is showing as 10.4. Because you know for standby router there is by default preemption enabled. As we seen in HSRP that preemption is disabled only for the active router. But for the standby router, preemption is by default enabled. So anybody can preempt to the standby router. Same over here. Now earlier R2 was the standby router. Now I have configured GLBP on R3 and R4. And R3 is having IP address 10.3 and R4 is having IP address 10.4. So now who will become the standby router? R4 will become the standby router because it is having higher IP address as compared to R2. Now who is the standby router? Standby router is 10.4, and who is the active router? Active router is 10.1. So now this R3 is in the listen state. What is the weight R3 is having by default weight? What is the load balancing by default round robin? Now total you are seeing four group members. Now this information are all same which you are seeing on all the devices. There are four forwarders, forwarder 1, 2, 3, 4. Now R3 is in the active state for third forwarder. See, for the third forwarder, R3 is the active because R3 is the third forwarder. It is having a MAC address ending with 03 and this is physical MAC address. Then for all the remaining forwarders, R3 will go in the listen state. And this all are the same information as we are seeing. Now on R4, if you will see, show GLBP. R4 is now in the standby state. The state is standby. Who is the standby router? Standby router is local, that is myself. Who is the active router? Active router is 10.1. Over here, there are you are seeing the group information of all the four devices, the MAC address and the IP address. And over here, you are seeing the information of the AVF. This information is of AVF. and R4 is the fourth forwarder. So R4 will be in the active state for the fourth forwarder. For all the remaining forwarders, R4 will be in the listen state. Now what I will do, I will go on R5 and I will configure Glbp on R5 also. Interface fast ethernet 0/0, Glbp 1 IP 10.10. Now, you know now there can be maximum 4 forwarders in a group. So now R5 cannot be the fifth forwarder over here because already we are having 4 forwarders in a group. So there can be not fifth forwarder, not possible, because maximum 4 forwarders are only allowed in a group. Now if I go on R1 and if I do show Glbp, you will see that there are only 4 forwarders now. There are total 4 forwarders. And who are there 4 forwarders? R1, you can see from over here the physical MAC address, R2, R3 and R4. Now R5 is not a fifth forwarder, or it is not replaced by any other forwarder. So once the forwarder is selected by the AVG, they are the forwarders, that is R1, R2, R3 and R4. But in the group members, you are seeing that the information of R5, because in my Glbp group, R5 is also participating now. R5 is also a group member of my Glbp. R5 is no longer forwarder. So R5 information is not seeing in the AVF information, but R5 is participating in my Glbp. So in the group members, you will see the information of R5 also. If I'm having one more device, R6, so you will see the information of R6 also over here. So R5 is having the MAC address 555, and what is the IP address? It is 10.5. And now R5 will be the standby router over here, because R5 is having the higher IP address as compared to 10.4. So R5 can be standby router. You can see over here, R5 is the standby router, because for the standby role, there is by default preemption enabled. So anybody can preempt to the standby router. Earlier the standby router was 10.4, but now I have configured Glbp on 10 R5 also, and it is having the higher IP address, then R5 has become the standby router. Even though R5 is the standby router, but still R5 is not the forwarder. So my traffic will not flow from R5, my traffic will go from R1, R2, R3 and R4 only. Okay. So this is how the basic configuration of Glbp, how you can read the output of Glbp, because if you see in HSRP, the output is very small. If you will see in VRRP, the output is very small. But if you will see in Glbp, show Glbp, so the output is very quite lengthy. You see, the output is very large. So this is how you will read the output of Glbp. And now I have shown you how to configure Glbp over here. Now see, what is the virtual IP I'm using? 10.10. So to this PC, that is PC number PC6, I will assign a default gateway of 10.10, IP default gateway 10.10. And now I will say that this user can reach to my internet 8.8.8. Yes, this user is able to reach to the internet. So this is the basic configuration of Glbp. Now we will, not now, in the next video we will start with the Glbp load balancing and all, what is the use of redirection timer. You will see everything in Glbp. Show Glbp. If I want to change the priority, so how can I change the priority? Let's say I want that R2 should become the active AVG now. So to change priority, I will go on fast ethernet 0/0, Glbp 1. What is the priority? The priority I will put as, let's say, 150. But still R2 will not become the active router. Why? Because by default, preemption is disabled for the active router. So R2 will not become the active router, but R2 will become now the standby router, because R5 was having the priority 100 and this time R2 is having the priority 150. So now R2 can become the standby router, but R2 cannot become the active router. In show GLBP, R2 is my standby router. But who is the active router? Active router is 10.1. It is having priority 100. I am having priority 150, but I cannot be the active router. Why? Because by default, preemption is disabled. As we have seen, everything is the same logic applies over here, which we have seen in HSRP. If I want that R2 should preempt, so I need to enable preemption GLBP1 preempt. That's it. Now R2 will become the active router. See. Now who is the active router? Active router is local, that is myself, because now my preemption is enabled. And now who will become the standby router? R5 will become the standby router because it will be having the higher IP address, because priorities are same. So now next thing is IP address. See, 10.5, R5 is the standby router currently. Who is the active router? It is myself. And these are the same forwarder information. Forwarder 1, forwarder 2, forwarder 3, and forwarder 4. This is R1, R2, R3, R4. So you know, you have now seen that how to change the priority and how to enable preemption for the AVG. So in the next video, we will see what is load balancing, how to change load balancing, what is this lower one, upper one indicates, what are the waiting and all, what is redirection timer, forwarder timer, that we will continue in our next part. Okay guys, thank you for now, see you in the next video.